Hey everybody, Attic VIP here, and this is just a continuation of our video that we just did of the Halloween spawn update. So I just wanted to let you guys know that if you've seen my past videos, you've noticed that Pentlock and I like to build a lot. And every server we've been to, we've built like crazy. So, I mean, what else is there to do except for build, build, build in this game? You know, it's a block game. So that's what we do. So basically, we decided to go crazy on our next build, and we're going to give you a little tour, and I hope you enjoy. So this is our town. We've got some really cool builders in our town. We decided to redo the road because we liked it so much. As you can tell, down here we ran out of resources because this road is done from all resources. Nothing is spawned in the game. Basically, we go mining and we do all the resources ourselves. So that's the reason why it's so expensive and why there's big blue gaps, because we ran out of resources. So in the background you can see our castle that we built. Yes, that castle was built block by block. Not one single thing spawned in, and no world edit, no creative. So our motto is go big or go home. So we decided to do that. We've got a slime fund building over here, so if you guys need to use any of the slime fund tools, we have them all labeled. And we also have the enchanter here and the disenchanter. And if you're going to use these machines, please bring your own coal, because it runs off of coal. So all your basic machines. Got the smeltery auto light, so when you stand on the pressure plate, it automatically lights with a flint and steel, and we even did it in glass underneath so you could see how to do it yourself. So, oh, there's a familiar face I see. Hey, Pentlock.
Oh. Hello, how's it going?
You're just sitting in the stairs.
Yes, chilling out.
So, I was just explaining to everybody a little bit about the town and this magnificent castle that that's in front of us.
Yeah, it took us a whole 5 days to build the outside of the castle, and I think it's been a week decorating the interior.
Oh, I can't wait to get inside and show that off.
Yeah, but so, I heard you were talking a little bit about the slime fund thing.
Yeah.
Maybe we should go ahead and take a look at some of our farms down there that our residents can use.
Okay, let's do that. This is a little house somebody built. So this is a public farm here. So if you decide that you needed to grow some crops, you know, you just come by and grab them and make sure you replant, please. And we've got another portal just in case you need to go to the Nether. You can go there. And then here for our town members, we have a zombie and skelly spawner, and it's downstairs. So we'll go down here.
Which, I'm going to have to correct you on that. It's not just town members. This is actually open. Anybody can actually use it, but town members are the ones who get the most benefit because they live here.
Oh, yeah, and they can open up the chests. There's some loot down there. There's some loot down there. And for those of you wondering why there aren't any spawning, the way we built this, it takes kind of a water elevator and a shuttle system. So it does take a little bit of time for them to pop down, but once they get going, you just stand here and whack away. Hello? Hello?
Yeah.
Oh, there we go. And they're one-hit kills, by the way. So, they just stand in this area right here, and they'll start spawning. I guess maybe we should add some spawners to it, huh?
Yeah, that might help out if we had a few more spawners. We gotta go hunting for some, though.
Yeah.
Find us some more spawners.
Maybe someone will auction some off.
Yeah, maybe.
There we go. one-hit kill is really awesome. Helps players that don't have strong weapons or slash fix be able to, you know, get some XP. Okay, so we'll go back up here. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba.
Now on to my favorite of the grinders.
Oh, I done fell in a hole. We need to fix that.
Yeah, I haven't completed the road yet.
So, if you can't tell, this is a blaze spawner, simply by the banners. And we got some skelly horses in here. And this is where all of the loot goes into, and you can get your loot after you get done killing. And as you can tell, this one, it comes down pretty immediately, so this one would probably be the best one to use until we get more spawners in the other ones. And then over here, we've got the enchantment table, and we've got some ink sacks you can buy here. So if you need to enchant anything, you can buy some blue ink sacks or lapis lazuli. These are not one kill, one hit kills, so you definitely need to bring a good sword. And then let's see if we got any. Yep, got a few blaze rods. Alright, Pent, you want to explain the next spawner?
Well, real quick, right here for residents, we got ourselves a cow farm.
Ooh.
So, these doors are set up so that only residents can get in. Nobody else will be able to get in here. So if anybody needs beef or leather or anything like that, feel free to come in here to the cow spawner if you belong to our town.
Wow, I didn't even know we had this. When'd you do this?
Oh, I did it day before yesterday.
Oh, cool. Good job, huh?
How do you think I got that entire inventory load of leather?
Oh, yeah. Makes sense.
Alright. Now I move over here. If Attic, you'll probably need to fly up, showing our little symbol that you spent so much time working on.
Alrighty. So that is coal and gold blocks, and that took a long while to get resources for that. And then we did the decorative terracotta design around with the sea lanterns. So at nighttime, is it nighttime right now or is it daytime? It's daytime.
It's daytime.
So no mobs will spawn here. So,
over here, we have a detector light that'll tell us when the chests down there get full.
Yeah. That was a pain in the keister to do. Not really, just time-consuming, more than anything. Running the redstone and figuring the configurations so that so that the wires don't cross and get cross signals. Alrighty, go down here.
It's a little bit of a walk, but not bad.
It's definitely worth it, though.
If you're a town member, may I remind you?
Yes.
Because we get down here, and we have chests full of items.
Yeah, so, oh wow, look at all those crystals, all the shards. Fish, so you'll never go hungry, because if you live in this town, because this is free, and you'll never need lighting, because you can just make your prismarine crystals, and there's a trash can here, too, in case you need to throw anything away.
And please keep in mind, if you're a town member, you'll have access to this, but please only take what you need, don't be stingy.
Yeah, because, did you make all of these chests accessible to town
no,
members?
Just the bottom ones.
Okay, good. Because, yeah, as you can tell, we got multiple layers of each one of those up there. So, definitely want to make sure you guys don't take away from other town members. What's a cooked fish doing in there? That's weird. throw that away. Alrighty. So, I guess I'll head back up. We like to keep everything nice and lit up, too. Definitely want to make sure you don't get any mobs spawning in this area, because we like to keep our town safe.
That is true. Not only that, but nicely, the town protection system stops mob spawns.
Yeah, so the only places that do have spawning are our spawners, right?
Yes.
Alright, that makes sense. Well, there is one house that I'd like to showcase in our town review. This gentleman came over to this server from one of my faction servers. His name's 8-Bit Gamer. If you see him in game, say what's up. He's a really cool guy. He's got some really awesome artistic abilities. He's still working on this house because we just built this house. But he's got his slime fun setting up over there. Then all of his inventory and stuff here. The cool thing about his house, if you look up, he's got different colored roof. I haven't really ever seen anyone do that before, so I thought that his was really cool. That's bone, by the way. This white material, it's bone block. You don't see that every day in builds. I think it adds, because of the shadowing, the bone marrow in the center, gives it a nice look. And then this guy here, Monkey Man, he came over to us from a different town. And he is one hell of a creative guy. He's just a really, really cool guy, too, just to talk to in general. He's got a lot of cool ideas, and I don't want to go through his house all the way down here because he's got a lot going on down there, but if he does show you, then by all means, let him show you. Penn, I'm going to fly up and do a kind of a flyby of the castle. Is that okay?
Yeah, that'd be fine, and actually, I think that after you do your flyby, that maybe we ought to wait for the inside until the next time.
Okay, yeah, we can do that. So, Pentlock did the outside. Well, I did some too, but he is the, I guess you would call, architect of the Attic VIP and Pentlock duo. He really knows how to throw down some awesome architecture. I mean, multi-layered walls. It's amazing. And it's like this all the way around. And at nighttime, all of the lava glows. And you really get a really cool look with all of the glowing lava going around. But yeah, you can tell. This is not something that you would build, you know, overnight. It took us 5 days to build, and the reason why it took so long to build is because of the intricate architecture.
Detail.
Yeah, the detail that we've added. So I wish it was nighttime so you could see it. Maybe in the next video it'll be nighttime, and we can just do a faraway shot. But we stayed up 20 hours a night, 20 hours a day pretty much, building this thing, just sleeping in our computer chairs, taking shifts. But yeah, that's it. If you guys have any comments about the castle that maybe you, on the outside, that you guys would like to share, please, definitely put in the comments below and hit the like button and subscribe, because we're always doing some really cool videos. So,
and don't forget, if you want to be able to get updates on when the next videos come out, hit that bell icon.
Mm-hmm. That is for sure. Well, Pent, I think that we are done with this video, sir, and we'll catch you guys on Castle Continuation Part 2. Attic VIP signing out.